As you start importing your files into your editor, it's best to organize your timeline in a way that will make working on your project as easy as possible. Before adding any files to the timeline, if your software allows, you should adjust the size of your project or canvas. For instance, if you want to produce your video as a 1920 by 1080 video, you should make sure that your project is set to edit at that size. If you change the project size, you may need to readjust any files already on the timeline to fit your project's dimensions. In addition to the project size, there may be additional project settings you'll want to change, like the canvas background color or the project's frame rate. The beginning of the editing process is a good time to make these adjustments. Once your project is set up, you can start adding files to the timeline. The timeline is where you're going to edit your footage. Everything from cutting away parts you don't want to adding materials to create the look, feel, and the sound of your video. Keeping your content organized by tracks will help you stay organized throughout the editing process. As you add materials, if you have a separate audio track, add that to the bottom track, typically track one. Next, add the main video recording. If you have multiple recordings, you can add them all right now. You can then add any secondary footage, web camera video, images, or graphics, making sure to keep like objects on the same track. In some cases, you may be stacking multiple graphics or objects all at the same point in the video. It's okay to use as many tracks as you need. As you add content to your timeline, one concept to be aware of is the timeline Z order. Z order is the layer order that objects appear. For instance, in Camtasia, objects on a lower timeline, like track 3, will appear to be beneath objects on a higher track, like track 4 or 5, but above anything on track 2. Knowing this will allow you to stack multiple objects and have them not get lost on the canvas. At this point, you don't need to add anything besides your main audio and video footage. In the next step, we'll take a look at basic editing.